Duterte's resignation as education chief also comes as a new study shows students in the Philippines are lagging behind in terms of creative thinking. In its 2022 cycle, the Program for International Student Assessment ranked the Philippines 60th out of 62 participating countries and economies. An earlier study by PISA also showed that Filipino students were among the lowest scorers in reading, math, and science. Although considered a soft skill, advocacy group PBED says creative thinking is a cornerstone of a person's development and a factor in employability.
Yung creative thinking and mga soft skills na ito, basic skills din to na tinitingnan ng mga employers by the time these students graduate. So kung lagapak yung mga mag-aaral natin dito, mas lalo talagang lalaki yung problema sa employability nila once they graduate.
The Marcos administration urged to seek a seasoned professional in the education sector to replace Sara Duterte. This is education advocacy group PBED. Expresses concerns over Duterte's resignation amid ongoing reforms. These include an academic calendar shift and the implementation of the so-called Matatag curriculum, which revises the K-10 program to focus on literacy and math skills.
Ideally, gusto natin someone na pabad sa education sector and someone who has fought the battles talaga for education reform kasi napakalaki and napakalalim ng mga problema ng education. Napakalaki ng bureaucracy, no? 28 million students, 900,000, close to a million teachers, and then 40,000 schools. So parang kung haharapin nito ng isang tao na baguhan or hindi masyadong familiar sa education sector, it's going to mahirap gawin and hindi pwedeng hit the ground running. So kailangan natin ng tao na maalam, may experience dyan. Kasi hindi na kailangan mag-warm up sa pwesto na to para madali silang makagawa ng mga desisyon.
Senator Sherwin Gatchalian reveals the Senate is working with the Chinese embassy to determine the real citizenship of controversial Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go. Gatchalian earlier bared new documents of a certain Go Huaping, which he believes is the real identity of the Bamban mayor. Gatchalian says it will be easy for the Chinese government to identify her since Mayor Go also has a Chinese passport.
The committee is already doing that. In fact, we sent letter to the committee to already initiate proceedings coordinating with the Chinese embassy. I understand there are protocols that we have to go through the Department of Foreign Affairs. We cannot go straight to the Chinese embassy because of these protocols, but we are coordinating and getting relevant information. We also have records that between 2008 and 2011, Alice Go and Go Huaping flew to China using different passports.
Meanwhile, Senator Gatchalian hopes a co-waranto case against the mayor will be filed soon to stop her from running in the midterm polls. Go earlier said she plans to seek re-election.
All of these pieces of evidence that we gathered should be used by the Office of the Solicitor General in their filing of a co-waranto case. That will send a signal to those who are thinking of doing the abusing the late registration process and eventually running for public office. I hope someone in Banban, at least one out of that 50,000, will file a case to challenge her citizenship.
Yeah.
Because it's true that COMELEC is ministerial in the receiving of the certificate of candidacy, but the COMELEC will be triggered to investigate if someone from Banban, a registered voter, will challenge her citizenship. And I'm sure there will be.